and engage now with our patients and how we can continue to do that.
Can?
Yeah.
Good, good. I'll shout loudly working with our patients and the public, I mean, it's very important to us to be able to do that, very important for us to have caring and compassionate staff. And I know that what you say to me and what patients and their families say is that it's really, really important. We do have many, many staff, I mean, some are here tonight, that go the extra mile for patients and their families. Staying with women who are in labour when they're due to go off shift so they can stay and see the baby delivered. Bringing in piles of Metro newspapers every morning for patients on wards so they've got something to read. But not every member of staff is like that. And don't get the impression that I'm saying we're perfect because we're not. But we've got a lot of great staff who go the extra mile. The kinds of things that we're doing with our staff, we're looking at who and how we recruit staff, because I think we're looking for a certain type of person to work at Imperial. We've got very clear induction, so when they start, it's clear about what we expect from them, and then we support that with training, and Dr. Ochoa, you heard from earlier, has led quite a big and successful programme, helping staff talk to patients and their families about cancer and cancer diagnosis. Which is very difficult, A, to be on the receiving end of it, and B, to be talking to patients and families about that. We've also got McMillan, as you've seen, working with us, and we've got a number of volunteers now from McMillan who come in and walk the patient pathway with patients so that we can involve them, we can engage with them, and goodness help us, they might be leading the care, and certainly listening to the case study about the 90-year-old lady who was very clear about what she wanted. From her care. Most of our patients and families do say they feel involved, but we're always mindful that we need to remind staff and keep them focused on that, involving, including, working in partnership. The other area that this brings to mind for me, I guess, is how we look after our staff, and all of you know that if in your working environment you feel cared for, you're more likely to be caring to your colleagues and to people around you. And so things like health and well-being, very important areas, as well as removing obstacles in our staff's way to stop
some people
being caring and compassionate, which involves patients in care. And I think, I suppose, my sort of chip into this whole buildings and environment debate is that a lot of our staff are working in quite difficult buildings, difficult environments, and while that alone won't mean that they...
Charing Cross is only 41 years old.
...are working well. We need to be creating working environments that mean patients' needs better, give better access facilities, better environments for patients to move around, and they're not moving all over our sites all of the time, and that our staff feel that the working environment supports the care that they want to give. So I'm not complacent about what we're doing, but I do think many, many of our staff do a great job in this area. They're working in partnership with patient groups, the Kidney Association, the Stroke Association. They've got small focus groups in paediatrics, and many of the patients contribute to the paediatric charitable work. So there are pockets of examples where some of you I know are already involved in this area. We will want to go on doing all of this with you, certainly across all of the things.